Hi everyone, this is Jim. This video is an update to an earlier video I did about how to use Sabaki and Leela Zero, and that video described how to download those programs and configure them to work together. This is Sabaki here. It's a user interface that displays a Go board, and then Leela Zero is an AI that will compute Go moves and win rate probabilities for you using the latest neural net technology. So it's a fun thing to do, but there was a change recently. This is the latest version of Sabaki, and they changed where they do the configuration of the AI, which they call an engine. So previously, there was a Manage Engines underneath the Engines tab up here, or the Engines dropdown, and it's not there anymore. So what you have to do is you have to go to the File menu, and you go to Game Info. So first time you bring up Sabaki, it starts a new game automatically. All the fields are blank, but there's some defaults filled in, like the current date. That's today when I'm making this video, in the Comey. You can fill in the names of the players, but what I want to draw your attention to is this pull-down. This is where you can choose to play manually or to and attach an engine. And I already have a couple engines configured here. They're just two different it's two different versions of Leela with different neural weights. You won't have that at first. The first time you bring up Sabaki, you will need to create an engine and add it. And what you do that with this Manage Engines forms. You click on that, and then this part is what is described in that previous video. After you download Sabaki and run it, and download Leela Zero and run it, this is how you configure Sabaki to look at Leela Zero. And these are the two instances of Leela Zero that I have, and these are the weights files. You can see they have very long names. But anyway, that was actually the main purpose of this video. And if you haven't seen my previous video and you're interested in Sabaki and Leela Zero, you can go back and watch that now. And just to remember that you have to use this trick with File Menu to Game Info to this drop down here to get to Manage Engines. Once you know that, then the rest of the video will make sense, and it's still valid. So so if you want to, you can pause this video now and go back and learn about Sabaki and Leela Zero from the previous video. What I'm going to do with the rest of this video is just go over some of the new features that I've discovered. They might not be new with this release, but they are new to me anyway, and talk about them. So maybe if you've already seen the other video, you can keep watching and might learn a few things. So first of all, in the Help menu, you can see I'm at version 0.50.1. That's the recently released version. You can check for updates and see that that's still the latest version. So we're still current as of today. One thing that I thought was kind of interesting here was they have this new thing called Manage Games. Well, it's the first time I've noticed it. And when you bring it up, it's blank and you can add games. And actually, I've already added games. You just can't see them. So I think it's still a little bit buggy. But let's see, if I go and add from an existing SGF file, say here's a recent game I played on PandaNet and then saved. Then suddenly all these other games, these are games that I've saved previously, they all show up. So there's another game I played on PandaNet, and here's a game called the 16 Soldiers game, which is a classic game played in 1933 between Go Sagan with the white pieces and Kosugi Tei with the black pieces. So what I wanted to show you using this is, first of all, you can find, also with this Game Info tab, this is where we got to Manage Engines. You can also find info about the game, as you might expect, the names of the players, where they played. I filled in this 16 Soldiers game. I learned that from Sensei's Library. That was the name of this game. And then there's a little bit of information about the status of the tournament down here. It says that Go Sagan ran one round one by default, and now this must be the round two game in the Ote tournament of 1933. Let's see. You can scroll through the game. On the view menu, you can show the game tree. So this is the list of moves that make up the game, and you can just scroll down through it, or you can use the mouse moves. It's kind of an interesting game, actually. Black starts off with 2-3-3 points, and Go Sagan plays the 4-4, and then black takes the Tengen, and we get a couple of moves here. Notice that white is splitting these stones apart, not letting the Tengen connect up with this stone on the side, I guess. I guess that's the idea. Anyway, another new feature I found I wanted to illustrate by going to the end of the game. Let's go all the way, scroll all the way down to the end. And at the end, black resigned. So Go Sagan, who was white, won this game. And you might want to, you might wonder if you're a new player like me, not particularly experienced, why is black resigning this position? It still seems, well, I don't know, the areas seem kind of settled, but it might be difficult to count all the points. So the new feature that I noticed under play, they have a thing called estimate. And that will actually estimate the score for you. And it says in this position, white is winning by 9 points. And I guess black doesn't see any way to overcome this. You can actually play around with this a little bit by clicking on the stone. So this stone and this line to here is all given as white's property, white's territory. So, but if you click on that stone, that converts it to black's territory. And now white's margin has been reduced. And then what if black keeps those stones? And all of a sudden white is only, say if black keeps this stone and captures this stone, white is only leading by 1 point, and then maybe black can nibble off another stone here, and suddenly black is winning. So, you know, it's still a close game from my point of view, but I guess black didn't see any way to accomplish all of this in the final position of the game, and he resigned. Okay, so I just wanted to go through and show some of the new features here. Let's go back to one of my games. So we go to Manage Games. At least within a session, it always remembers these. And like I said, you can do that trick of loading another game and these games seem to come back. So it seems like a nice feature. It's just not quite fully there yet. So let's look at this game. This is a game I lost on PandaNet recently. And let's scroll through it and get up to the critical point. I've looked at this before, and so I know where the critical point is. It's coming up soon. I'm white in this game, and actually I have a pretty good position. And let's go ahead and attach the engine. So let's see, we go to game info. So now you see the game info has the information about this game. It was played on the Internet Go server. It was played on PandaNet, but I guess, okay, it calls them all Internet Go servers. anyway, the date the game was played, or is that today's date? And the players and the Comey. So it was an even game between two players. We're both at rated 12K plus on PandaNet. I wanted to attach a engine here. Let's get the latest. They're the most recent Leela that I have. Say OK. It takes a while before that registers. You can't immediately go here and say toggle the analysis. What we can do is you can look at the engine sidebar. Looks like it's come up to speed. I usually leave that off, but you can see it writing stuff to the sidebar here. While it's running and starting up. So I guess it started up. Let's turn that off and let's turn on the analysis. And yeah, it starts showing where it thinks white should play. It's white's move here. And it also starts showing the percentages. So that's like a winning percentage. So it thinks I've got a 90% chance of winning and I go on to lose. And this is right at the point in the game where I start to go astray. So let's, there's a win rate graph you can bring up. And the win rate graph, it looks like it's already done an evaluation up to this point. It shows how I was doing better up to this point, and then I start going downhill. Maybe it remembered this from before, because I've looked at this before. Anyway, it will just fill in with dots. If it knows the evaluation at one point and an evaluation at another point, it'll just draw a dotted line between them. But as you scroll through the game, it'll fill in the win rate graph. Anyway, so I'm at my peak here, or near my peak, and I start going astray. I play some moves. Well, I play this move here. And, I'm still winning after this, but the follow-up, first of all, that wasn't the most accurate move here. the moves the AI likes. It likes the shoulder hit over here, and likes the shoulder hit over here, and it likes running this stone out. And you can see that starting to happen. If you just hover your mouse over a particular move, it'll show a particular sequence of how it would play out. It looks like it started over here, and then on move three, it went to the bottom right corner, and then on move seven, it played the shoulder hit at the top. So it's kind of jumping around a little bit, but it likes white in this position, and it thinks white should continue. Looks like black has gotten territory along the side, but white is getting a lot in the center, and it seems like that's the right strategy here. So this move that I played, I threw in here, and maybe I just didn't handle it correctly from that point forward, because my evaluation goes down steadily after that. Well, it looked like the AI was extending there once. But another option here would be just to throw that stone away. It looks like if I just forget about that stone and play over here, I have a better chance of winning than if I continue to play with this stone, as I did in the game. And with each move that I play over here, my win rate goes down. So here, once again, well, I should cut over here rather than having played another stone here, I should cut rather than continuing. So now my win rate has dropped to 50%. And after a few more moves, it's down to about 10%. Yeah, so in this position here, give it a while for the numbers to settle down. So if I Hana here, I'd still be at like 12, 11%. That's a pretty steep drop from what was formerly a 90% chance of winning. So easy to go astray in this game. Anyway, this is one of the things you can do with the AI. And let's see, let's back up. I wanted to show you what you can do with this tree over here. You can put in some different moves. Say I like this move over here. Say I like trying to run this stone out. I can actually play that. And then I can see, well, how would black respond? And then I can play another move for myself. It still wants to play the shoulder hit, so let's play there. I'll cancel that. And then looks like black will block here. And then now it looks like I can dive in here. It looks like that's a better move at this point. Okay, so let's turn off the engine for a second, toggle the analysis. There's a little bit of a race condition because it's trying to make the move before I select it. So that when you saw that error message popping up, that's because I clicked on that stone just as the AI was deciding to move there. When it's attached like that, it's going to try and make a move for you. Anyway, let's scroll back to the beginning. And then I wanted to show you another thing you can do. You can add comments. And there we are. So instead of diving in, I should play somewhere else, and this is one idea. So this now I can add a comment here. I can say this is an AI suggestion. And notice that in the graph up here, in the tree rather of moves, it highlighted that node or changed its color. So, you know, there's a comment there. And you can do similar things elsewhere. You can add lines and add comments, and you can, you know, make remarks about what the win rate percentage is. Another thing you can do is you can start highlighting areas, like maybe you want to highlight the idea that you could bring a stone out here. So you can mark that, and you might want to highlight this area. These are areas that white might consider moving at this point. And there's some other nice features. There's the arrow tool. Say you want to say you're projecting influence from this wall here and from this wall here. So it looks like this is, you know, white has some things going on here. Some options that are okay. So you can add these comments. And then it'll remember that in the game. When you save the game, it'll remember these. You go to File, Save, and the next time you pull it up, let's see, and you can save it back over itself. Here, let's hang on a second. Let's make sure I got the right game here. Let's go File, Game Info. So this is the game between Kirara and me. Okay, that's good. So I just want to write over the game that rather than creating a new copy. I mean, you can create a new copy as well, but might as well save that update. Yeah, let's just replace that. And now this has been saved, so you know, I'll have these comments the next time I come back to look at this game. Okay, let's check over the menu bar and see if there's anything I mentioned. So there is this Manage Games tab. We talked about that in Game Info. Under Play, you can, this is where the Estimate function is. At the end of the game, you can also score it. It may ask you to mark stones that are alive and dead, and then it does a similar thing to the Estimate, but it's like the final score. Under Edit, you can delete these variations that you added to the game tree over there. So there's, let's see. So this is what this cut and copy variations are doing. You can remove nodes or whole variations. Edit mode is this menu down at the bottom, which you can turn on and off. And you can toggle edit mode, or you can just select a particular tool from this menu, or you can select it from the edit menu down there. There's also a little menu here to get to edit. You can get to edit and to estimate from this menu as well. Let's see. So, and then there's navigation. There's navigation through the move tree. You can search for a comment or go to the end of a variation or go to the beginning. There's the engine sidebar. I showed that. This is where you turn the analysis on and off. This is where you can force the engine to play a move, have the engine play itself. And then there are all these view options showing the graph, the game tree, and the comments. Those are the ones I've talked about. And yeah, that's it. I think I've covered everything. I hope you enjoyed this little summary of the functions of Sabaki and how you could use it with Leela Zero. And well, once again, if you want to upload and configure Sabaki and Leela Zero, the previous video that I made has a good description of how to do that. And I'm going to include a pointer to that video in the description to this one, and also at the end right here. You should be able to click on it and it'll take you to that video now.